Chairman, you ready?
I'm Glenn Holloway. I'm the co-owner of Snow Hollow Farm in Sausalito County here in Virginia. We produce grass-fed beef, pasture poultry, eggs, and all on 10 acres. Everything that we raise is sold directly from the small farm to pasture. I'm also the founder of Bow Farm Youth Foundation, which is a regenerative farming education center that trains new farmers and vendors to develop holistic, successful farming enterprises that are profitable without government subsidies. In support of the need, though, I'd like to present three areas of consideration today. The first is infrastructure resiliency. Prior to returning to farming, I was the subject matter expert on critical infrastructure as part of the Department of Homeland Defense. In that capacity, I read numerous studies pertaining to the effects of infrastructure failure, especially on the food supply. Extensive research has concluded that in the event of an infrastructure failure or natural disaster, a community's ability to survive and strive depends directly upon its ability to rapidly provide shelter, local fresh water, and a network of sustainable local farms producing a healthy variety of farm products. Small farms are essential to the resiliency of the local infrastructure. Second point is local economic growth. History is replete with examples showing the key to economic recovery at the local level is through small, local businesses. And Agriculture Secretary Tom Vilsack spoke earlier this week about the unprecedented opportunity to economically revolutionize America's rural towns and communities through the USDA's program, Know Your Farmer, Know Your Local Food Initiative. The initiative supports the expansion of farmers' markets and community-supported agriculture by linking local production with local consumers. The USDA recognizes the critical need to rapidly increase small farms serving their local communities. Small farms spur local economic growth. And lastly, farming for the future. The USDA has estimated that we need about 8 million farmers in America to feed our country and meet its food needs. The legislation in the Bonita Bill allows the small farmers to survive and strive, as stated previously by the internationally renowned farmer and author Joel Salatin, who actually is in Australia right now teaching sustainable farming. Our current right to farm legislation only preserves the rights of farmers to produce raw commodities at low margins to the value added by off-site processors, marketers, and distributors. The result is a few gigantic farms and fundamentally segregated food and farming systems. New farmers can't afford to get on the land without incurring insurmountable debt, and old farmers with small farms can't afford to stay on their land under the current farming paradigms. Would you be willing to work as hard as farmers do and make only 19 cents on the dollar? It is no wonder farm kids grow up and leave the family farm to join the corporate world. We must loosen the chains on small farms so that farming is sustainable and profitable in order to attract young people back to farming. In summary, the current Right to Farm Act doesn't represent the needs and interests of the average Virginia farmer who holds a master's in diversity of agrarian arts, but rather the interests of monoculture industrial agriculture. This creates a system of land barons and serfs that harken back to the Middle Ages in Europe. If Virginia wants to preserve the historical status as well as the reputation of Virginians for lovers, especially on Valentine's Day today, it needs to recognize that Virginia's small farms produce the visceral and economic connections people seek through local food. The Bonita Bill is critical to preserving Virginia's past and protecting Virginia's future. I greatly appreciate your time and your support of the Bonita Bill. Thank you.
Thank you very much.